Chemistry Class 12 Chapter Number 1. S and P Block Elements. Question Number 2. Part 2. How acidic, basic and amphoteric behavior of oxides is explained. Basic, acidic and amphoteric behavior of oxides. Oxides of alkali metals are basic in nature. For examples, Na2O, base, react with H2SO4 acid, and form H2ONa2SO4. Sodium sulfate oxides of B-sulfur are amphoteric in nature. For example, SO3, acidic, react with Na2O, base, and form Na2SO4 sodium sulfate. Salt oxides of beryllium, Be, beryllium are amphoteric. For example, BeO react with NaOH, base, and form Na2BO2 sodium berylate. BeO react with H2SO4, acid, and form BSO4 beryllium sulfate and H2O water. The trend in acid-base behavior. Acidity increases from left to right, ranging from strongly basic oxides on the left to strongly acidic ones on the right, with an amphoteric oxide, aluminum oxide, in the middle. An amphoteric oxide is one which shows both acidic and basic properties. Question 3. Why the elements of group 1A are called alkali metals? Elements of group 1A are metals, and their oxides and hydroxides are alkaline in nature. For example, oxides of sodium, like Na2O and NaOH, react with an acid H2SO4. They form Na2SO4 and H2O sodium sulfate. Na2O react with sulfuric acid H2SO4 and form Na2SO4 sodium sulfate and H2O water. Two sodium hydroxide molecules react with sulfuric acid H2SO4 and form Na2SO4 sodium sulfate and H2O water. Question 4. Why all Ia group of metals have low ionization energies? All 1A group elements have one electron on their outermost shell. Except lithium, all alkali metal has strong shielding or screening effect. As a result, pull of nucleus on outermost electron decreases. That's why outermost electron of alkali metals may be removed easily using low energy. Question 5. Why do the group 1A metal show strong electropositive character? The metals which lose outermost electrons easily and give a stable cation are called electropositive. And group IA metals lose their outermost single electron easily to complete their outermost stable octet. Therefore, they are electropositive metals. Question 6. Why do group 1A metals show strong reducing properties? All alkali metals have one electron in their outermost shell, and on losing one outermost electron, their octet is completed, which is a stable state. Therefore, they try to lose their valence electron and all behave as good reducing agent. Question 7. Why different colors are imported by the atoms of the group 1A metals to the flame? The outermost electron of group 1A is NS1. This electron is loosely held with the nucleus. When an element is brought to a flame of a burner, the electron absorbs some energy and goes to higher energy orbital and is called excited. This excited electron absorbs energy during process of excitation. Atoms of different elements absorb different energies. Therefore, on de-excitation, they impart different colors to flame. Question 8. Why the elements of group 2A are called alkaline earth metals? 2A group members are metals. Their salts are found in earth and their oxides and hydroxides are alkaline in nature. Therefore, they are called alkaline earth metals. CaOH2SO4 from CaSO4 and H2OCaOH. 2H2SO4 forms CaSO4 and 2H2O. Question 9. Why do the group 2A earth metals have high melting and boiling points than alkali metals? The alkaline earth metals have 2 electrons in their outermost shell, whereas group 1A have 1 electron in their outermost shell. Therefore, there are strong metal bonds among group 2A. Therefore, 2A members are harder and stronger than group 1A members. Therefore, the melting and boiling point of group 2A members are higher than group 1A members. Question 10. How do group 1 metals resemble with group 2 metals? Both group 1AA and group 2A members are metals. They are isoelectronic up to subshell. For example, Li equals 3, 1s 2, 2s 1, Be equals 4, 1s 2, 2s 2. They form alkaline oxides and hydroxides, for example, Na2O, MgO, and NaOH, CaO2. They are good conductors for heat and electricity, can react with halogens to form salts. For example, NaCl and CaCl2. Question 11. How do group 1A metals differ from group 2A metals? Group 1A metals 1. They have 1 electron in their outermost cell. 2. They are monovalent M3. They are soft metals. 4. Their melting boiling points are low. 5. Their carbonates are soluble in water. 6. Their carbonates are stable towards heat. Na2CO3, no reaction observed. 7. Their hydroxides are stable towards heat. Group 2A metals 1. Their atoms have 2 electrons in their outermost cell. 2. They are divalent M2-3. They are hard metals. 4. Their melting and boiling points are high. 5. Their carbonates are insoluble in water. 6. Their carbonates decompose on heating. 7. Their hydroxides decompose on heating. Question 12. Discuss the metallic and non-metallic character of group 4A elements. Metallic and non-metallic character of group 4A elements. Metallic character of group 4 elements increase from top to bottom. Carbon and silicon are non-metals. Germanium is semi-metal. Tin and lead are metals.